I didn't know you were awake. I swear.
Is this another prison?
No. I mean, I don't think so.
Then where am I? Tell me.
I beg your forgiveness and your blessing. I am but a humble servant. You are back in Haven, my lady. They say you saved us. The breach stopped growing, just like the mark on your hand. It's all anyone has talked about for the last 3 days.
So a trial happens now, I suppose.
I don't know anything about that. I'm certain Lady Cassandra would want to know you've wakened. She said, at once.
And where is she?
In the chantry, with the Lord Chancellor. At once, she said.
Chain her! I want her prepared for travel to the capital for trial.
Disregard that, and leave us.
You walk a dangerous line, Seeker.
The breach is stable, but it is still a threat. I will not ignore it.
Let me guess. You need my help.
You have done plenty. Your actions will be taken into account by the new Divine.
Have a care, Chancellor. The breach is not the only threat we face.
Someone was behind the explosion at the Conclave. Someone most holy did not expect. Perhaps they died with the others, or have allies who yet live.
I am a suspect?
You, and many others.
But not the prisoner.
I heard the voices in the temple. The Divine called to her for help.
So her survival, that thing on her hand, all a coincidence.
Providence. The Maker sent her to us in our darkest hour.
5 minutes ago you wanted me dead, and now I'm your savior.
I was wrong. Perhaps I still am. I will not, however, pretend you were not exactly what we needed when we needed it.
The breach remains, and your mark is still our only hope of closing it.
This is not for you to decide.
You know what this is, Chancellor. A writ from the Divine, granting us the authority to act. As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn. We will close the breach, we will find those responsible, and we will restore order, with or without your approval.
This is the Divine's directive. Rebuild the Inquisition of old. Find those who will stand against the chaos. We aren't ready. We have no leader, no numbers. And now, no chantry support.
But we have no choice. We must act now, with you at our side.
What if I refuse?
You can go if you wish.
You should know that while some believe you chosen, many still think you guilty. The Inquisition can only protect you if you are with us.
We can also help you.
It will not be easy if you stay, but you cannot pretend this has not changed you.
When I woke up, I certainly didn't picture this outcome.
Neither did we.
Help us fix this before it's too late. Does it trouble you?
I wish I could get rid of it.
We have need of it yet.
So you've mentioned.
What's important is that your mark is now stable, as is the breach. You've given us time, and Solas believes a second attempt might succeed. Provided the mark has more power.
You're the one they're calling the heroine.
You don't sound happy about that.
I'm not. Your people believe in the stone and have never been friendly to the chantry. I did not join the order to adjust my faith so easily, but I appreciate what the Inquisition is trying to do, and your role in it. Though you may find not many Templars do. We're a distrustful lot by nature.
Ugh.
I hope that wasn't meant to be me.
What? That?
You obviously don't like somebody.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool. And they may be right.
This Inquisition of yours wasn't the smartest move.
Thank you for the ringing endorsement. My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
There is a lot at stake.
You do not have to tell me that. You've said you don't believe you're chosen. Does that mean you also don't believe in the Maker?
No, I don't.
I suppose I should not be surprised. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us. Move! Now!
Pretender, you toy with forces beyond your ken, no more.
Whatever you are, I'm not afraid.
Words mortals often hurl at the darkness. Once they were mine, they are always lies. Know me. Know what you have pretended to be. Exalt the Elder One. The will that is Corypheus. You will kneel.
You'll get nothing out of me!
You will resist. You will always resist. It matters not. I am here for the anchor. The process of removing it begins now. It is your fault, Herald. You interrupted a ritual years in the planning, and instead of dying, you stole its purpose. I do not know how you survived, but what marks you as touched, what you flail at rifts, I crafted to assault the very heavens. And you used the anchor to undo my work. The gall.
do?
It is meant to bring certainty where there is none. For you, the certainty that I would always come for it. I once breached the Fade in the name of another to serve the old gods of the Empire in person. I found only chaos and corruption, dead whispers. For 1,000 years I was confused, no more. I have gathered the will to return under no name but my own, to champion Withered Tevinter and correct this blighted world. Beg that I succeed, for I have seen the throne of the gods, and it was empty. The anchor is permanent. You have spoilt it with your stumbling. So be it. I will begin again. Find another way to give this world the nation and God it requires. I will not suffer even an unknowing rival. You must die.
Your arrogance blinds you. Good to know. If I'm dying, it's not today!
Your determination brought us out of Haven. You are the creature's rival because of what you did. And we know it. All of us. The Inquisition requires a leader. The one who has already been leading it. You.
And just what are you going to do if I don't want this? I did my part at the breach, and in Haven. That should be enough.
We've all sacrificed, but we're not done. You're not done. If nothing else, Corypheus still wants you dead. If the Inquisition disappears, and it will, without you, you will be alone. I believe the Maker intended you for this. We need each other. But how you lead us, that is for you alone to determine.
The Inquisition will be a force to rival any in Thedas, in my name. Together we will defeat Corypheus and shake the world.
Wherever you lead us.
Have our people been told?
They have. And soon, the world.
Commander, will they follow?
Inquisition, will you follow? Will you fight? Will we triumph?
Everyone acting all inspirational jogged my memory, so I sent a message to an old friend. She's crossed paths with Corypheus before and may know more about what he's doing. She can help.
I don't have time for a meet and greet, Varric.
You'll get a lot out of this, and it's probably overdue. Just come up to the battlements. Trust me, it's complicated.
Well, then, we stand ready to move on both of these concerns.
On your order, Inquisitor.
I know one thing. If Varric has brought who I think he has, Cassandra is going to kill him.
Brilliant, isn't it? One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad, that should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping you wouldn't crush our village like an anthill. Sorry about that. Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
I was waiting for you to say something worth listening to.
If I did that, we'd be here all day.
There are things worse than silence.
You've clearly never been to the Magisterium's archive. That silence will eat you alive. I always assumed the Elder One behind the Venatori was a Magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of Magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very Magisters, a Darkspawn.
Clearly, the Imperium has no idea.
The Imperium is a land of lies built upon secrets, built upon falsehoods. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, but I assumed there had to be a kernel of it, somewhere. But no, it was us all along. We destroyed the world.
So you'll just stand here and whine about it then?
I could head south, try to stop the Venatori myself, spread a warning when they march. Wait! I already did that! I have no intention of letting Corypheus win. Not without someone from Tevinter standing against him. It would have been nice if you'd help stop Alexius. But that's not how things went. So be it. If it's all the same to you, I'd like to stay and help the Inquisition.
We can use all the help we can get.
No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you, either. You know that, yes?
That attitude must be why they kicked you out of the Imperium.
They didn't kick me out? Well, only because they never got around to it. Eventually, they might have. All I know is this. Corypheus needs to be stopped. Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
There must be some reason you haven't left. You can't want to stay.
Why? I have to be fond of you to agree with what you're doing. I do think you blunder about, Inquisitor, thrashing like a caged dragon at everything that displeases you. I still believe Corypheus needs to be stopped, and that I need to be here to help stop him.
I don't want your help. I don't need it.
At the moment. That could change. Corypheus was a Magister. He represents everything dark and terrible in my country. I have to help. Even if it means I stand on the sidelines watching, I'll do it. I need to know he's defeated. If that's meaningless to you, then tell me to go and I will.
No, I'm not asking you to leave.
Excellent. Then let's not belabor it further.
You knew where Hawk was all along!
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit!
You kidnapped me! You interrogated me! What did you expect?
I expected you to tell the truth! I told you what was at stake!
So I just hand her over on your say-so? It's okay, Hawk. This zealot isn't crazy. I promise. Look at her. She's finally lost it.
We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. First, Liliana and I searched for the hero of Ferelden, but she had vanished. Then, we looked for Hawk, but she was gone too. We thought it all connected, but no. It was just you. You who kept her from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawk would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy...
You did that out of spite.
I was protecting my friend.
Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawk most, Varric kept her secret.
She's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
You don't need to tell me that.
Oh, like I have no reasons to help the Inquisition finish this.
For the moment.
Fine. For the moment, I'd like to do what I can.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawk had been at the temple, she'd be dead too. You people have done enough to her.
I believed him. He spun his story for me and I swallowed it. If I'd just explained what was at stake, if I'd just made him understand. But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawk. Ah, here comes the hero of our age. Mighty tamer of the Order of Templars. Once lowly prisoner, now the fabled Herald of Andraste. A toast to you, my lady.
Sitting in a dark corner, drinking.
Yes! What of it?
It's pathetic.
You! I have watched you, even exalted you as you straddled the world. And I'm the one who raised you up.
Then go. The Inquisition doesn't need you.
How clear you make it. Corythia still lives. My work is not yet done. Leave me be, Inquisitor. Go, do what you must.
All right. Is there anything else that you've been hiding that I should know?
You want to hear about my childhood? Maybe what I had for breakfast? I told you what I knew when it became important.
If you truly want to help us, you have to decide whether you're on our side or on your own.
I'm not... I keep hoping none of this is real. Maybe it's all some bullshit from the Fade and it'll just... disappear. I know I need to do better. I'm sorry. Inquisitor, we really need to have a talk about your methods. The way you run this place, you get results. I can't argue with that, but the way you do it, you leave a lot of innocent people ground into the dirt behind you.
We're fighting an enemy who can tear open the sky. Some sacrifices have to be made.
Well, There's always a war, or a cause, or an injustice. You think I haven't heard this rant before? This all that matters is the goal and fuck the consequences thing of yours? I've seen where that road leads. Anders was the last guy I knew who thought like that, and he was an abomination. What's your excuse? The world has enough problems, Inquisitor. It doesn't need another monster. Try not to become one.
This thing is not a stray puppy you can make into a pet. It has no business being here.
Wouldn't you say the same of an apostate?
Inquisitor, I wondered if Cole was perhaps a mage, given his unusual abilities.
He can cause people to forget him, or even fail entirely to notice him. These are not the abilities of a mage. It seems that Cole is a spirit.
It is a demon.
If you prefer, although the truth is somewhat more complex.
I will have nothing to do with demons.
In fairness, Cole helped you against the Envy demon. You agreed to let him stay, even knowing his odd nature.
That was before we knew what it was. Honoring deals with demons is a swift path to an early grave.
In fact, his nature is not so easily defined.
Speak plainly, Solas. What are we dealing with?
Demons normally enter this world by possessing something. In their true form, they look bizarre, monstrous.
But Cole looks like a young man. Could it be possession?
No. He has possessed nothing and no one. And yet he appears human in all respects. Cole is unique, Inquisitor. More than that, he wishes to help. I suggest you allow him to do so.
I should hear what Cole has to say for himself. Where is he now?
He was right...
Haven. So many soldiers fought to protect the pilgrims so they could escape. Choking fear. Can't think from the medicine, but the cuts rack me with every heartbeat. Hot, white pain. Everything burns. I can't. I'm dying. I'm...
dead.
Get out of their heads!
They're in mine. Every breath slower. Like lying in a warm bath. Sliding away. Smell of my daughter's hair when I kiss her goodnight.
Gone.
Cracked brown pain. Dry. Scraping. Thirsty. Here.
Thank you.
It's all right. She won't remember me.
Demons have the power to cloud people's minds.
Yes. I used to think I was a ghost. I didn't know. I made mistakes. But I made friends, too. Then a Templar proved I wasn't real. I lost my friends. I lost everything. I learned how to be more like what I am. It made me different, but stronger. I can feel more. I can help.
Just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
Wait. You have a Grey Warden with you.
Warden Blackwall.
Your Blackwall? Duncan, my mentor, he spoke of you.
Duncan. Of course. Good man.
I'm Alistair. It's an honor to meet all of you. I wish it was someplace nicer.
You said all the Wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you? And also you, Blackwall?
Unfortunately, yes. When I'm talking or fighting, I can almost ignore it. But whenever things are quiet, I can hear it. It's like a song you can't get out of your head. Damned annoying, frankly.
I do not fear the calling. And worrying about it only gives it power. Anything Corypheus does will only strengthen my resolve.
How can Corypheus make all these Wardens hear the calling?
I have no idea. I suppose it's part of what he is. Corypheus is tied to the Blight, and not just a product of it like most Darkspawn. Wardens are connected to the Darkspawn too. That's how he seems able to control Wardens who get too close to him. And that's likely what he's doing here as well. Somehow.
We need the Warden's help. This is the worst possible time for such a lunacy.
I saw what a Blight did to Ferelden. If Wardens hadn't stopped it, there'd be no more Thedas. Warden Commander Clarell proposed some drastic things, blood magic and such, to prevent further Blights before we die. I protested. Maybe too loudly. And Clarell sent guards and... well... here I am. Wardens were gathering here, in the Western Approach. It's an old Tevinter ritual tower. I'm going to investigate. I could use some help.
I cannot believe the Grey Wardens could even conceive of such a plan. To seek out these old gods deliberately, in some bizarre attempt to preempt the Blight.
How many lives were lost during the last Blight? Corypheus notwithstanding, I don't blame the Wardens for acting instead of reacting.
They acted stupidly.
By trying to end the Blight forever?
Yes. Would it have worked? Do you know? Did they? The fools who first unleashed the Blight upon this world thought they were unlocking ultimate power. Forgive me. The entire idea is... unnerving.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
The names of those we lost. You must blame me for this. Those deaths are on your hands. It was your job to watch, to prepare us. Yes, it was my fault. But how was I to know what we really faced? The Red Templars are like nothing I've seen, and the Venatori hide their tracks well. I keep wondering if I could have done something different. When the first of my lookouts went missing, I pulled the rest back, awaiting more information. If they'd stayed in the field, they could have bought us more time. I was afraid to lose my agents, and instead we lost Haven.
You will be prepared next time.
I won't let this happen again. My people know their duty. They know the risks. They understand that the Inquisition may call upon them to give their lives. True. They're our soldiers. They'll do what we need them to. If Corypheus is cold, I must be colder. War demands sacrifices of us all.
You have remarkably little here on early Tevinter history. All these gifts to the Inquisition, and the best they can do is the Malefica Imperio. Trite propaganda. But if you want 20 volumes on whether Divine Galatea took a shit on Sunday, this is evidently the place to find it.
Then find another library. Don't whine to me about it.
I'm not whining.
Yes, you are.
Fine. Perhaps a little. I've good cause. Did I see something by Genitivi here? I could have sworn.
What is this about, Dorian?
When everyone returned, they told us about your tumble into the Abyssal Rift. You went into the Fade. Physically went in. You do realize this feat hasn't been performed in over 1,000 years. Corypheus and his contemporaries entered the Fade and began the Blights. In comparison.
That's not exactly comforting, Dorian.
Nor should it be. If you can walk in the Fade, others will try to follow. Who knows what secrets Corypheus has revealed? Not all of them will be as lucky as you. What they could unleash. My advice? Keep this quiet. Let them speculate. Too many will see this as a challenge.
Why should that be my concern?
Because if it's not just part of your legend, if they think it's real, they will come for you. Fear them or not, as you choose. But you've enough problems. There are enough idiots in the world who think if they just use enough blood magic, their problems will vanish. It's exactly the sort of thing I want to stop back home. This I don't need. What I do need is a copy of the Liberalum. I'll wager I can find Corypheus's real name. If I can prove he was a grasping ankle biter with no family to speak of, the luster would come right off.
Tell me something. Do you care about anything in the world beyond the Fade?
Ah. The Inquisitor turns a hawk-like gaze to me, penetrating deep into my most secret desires. Only not. I care deeply for many things beyond the Fade, just not you.
You're going to want to watch that attitude, Solas.
Why? Do you have another expert on the Fade hiding around here? Are you absolutely certain you won't need me? I volunteered to help Inquisitor. Rattle the bars if you like, but I chose to enter this cage.
Lord Eremond, any protection you thought you had has apparently been withdrawn. You will die by my hand.
Petty actions. Truth lies in the next world.
Writing does not come naturally to me, as I'm certain you can imagine.
Then find someone else to do it.
This must be in my own words, as if written by a dim-witted child. Historians will one day ask what happened at Adamant Fortress, in the Fade. I wasn't there. But others were. Their accounts must be recorded.
What you write could be used against the Inquisition.
You're worried what I'll say about you, I assume. Do not be concerned. I am a poor writer, but not unaware of the weight my words might carry. Something in particular you require?
I see I've touched a nerve.
I suppose I do need your help. You recall the demon at Therenfall? The one impersonating Lord Seeker Lucius? We never found the real Lord Seeker. Or his body. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars. Or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
They're gone. What difference does it make where they are?
I don't expect you to understand. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate...
This better not be about lending you money.
What? No, certainly not. I promise you.
Were the murderers targeting the Inquisition?
Leliana made inquiries that bore success. Comte Boisvert, a nobleman in Valroyo, claims to know who killed my messengers. He has a request. That you come when I meet him, so he's seen publicly conferring with you.
If I meet this Comte, he'd better not try to wheedle anything from me.
I will take full responsibility if that's the case, Inquisitor. I must know who killed my couriers just to harm my family. Will they now? You are exceedingly well informed, or not to have said you'd heard rumors at best.
A bit of subterfuge. This contact on your life is an ugly business. One the House of Repose deeply regrets. But this is Orlais. Even an assassin's word is his bond.
The House of Repose has some nerve sending a killer to greet us.
Hardly anyone in the League isn't trained for this, Inquisitor. The contract on Lady Montilet's life is so unusual, we felt the courtesy of an explanation was in order.
It is appreciated, Monsieur.
Your idea to seek out Du Parquet to revoke our orders is an interesting one. I wish you luck. I did not come to shed blood today, Inquisitor. Only to speak. Might I pass?
Not on your life.
As you wish.
What happened?
It's not what it looks like. Honestly, I would have preferred it if it were what it looks like. The Empress led me to believe I would be rewarded for betraying the Grand Duke. This was not what I hoped for.
You're telling me that Empress Celine left you naked and trussed like a roast duck?
Please, I beg you, don't tell Gaspard. The Empress beguiled me into giving her information about plans for troop movements in the palace tonight. She knows everything. Everything. The Duke's surprise attack has been countered before it ever began. She's turned it into a trap. The moment he strikes, she'll have him arrested for treason.
She'll be all prim, but here's you with your bits out.
Clever Celine. Even I'm impressed.
I'll protect you from Gaspard if you're willing to testify about Celine's trap.
I'll do anything. Anything.
We owe the court one more show, Your Grace.
Inquisitor?
I'm giving you a chance to end this peacefully. There's no need for more death. Corypheus is only using you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Really? You've already forgotten trying to kill me in the garden just a moment ago. You arranged for your brother to be at the ball so everyone would be watching him while you carried out your plan. So when the council emissary stumbled into the wrong room and found your assassins, you could pin the blame on Gaspard. The Empress, your brother, and the entire court, all here as your guests. A tempting target for Corypheus.
This is very entertaining, but you do not imagine anyone believes your wild stories.
That will be a matter for a judge to decide, cousin.
Gaspard, you cannot believe this. You know I would never... Gaspard?
At least this time, justice will be swift. Your Imperial Majesty, I think we should speak in private, elsewhere.
Your sister attempted regicide in front of the entire court, Gaspard.
You're the spymaster. If anyone knew this atrocity was coming, it was you.
You don't deny your involvement.
I do deny it. I knew nothing of Florian's plans. But you... you knew it all and did nothing.
I don't know which is better. That you think I'm all-seeing, or that you're trying so hard to play innocent and failing.
Enough. We will not bicker while Tevinter plots against our nation. For the safety of the Empire, I will have answers.
Every one of you is implicated. You all conspired to allow this to happen.
That's a bold claim, Inquisitor. Are you prepared to defend it?
You allowed the Grand Duke to sneak soldiers in, hoping he'd make a politically foolish move.
That's duplicitous, even for you, Celine.
Of course, Briala was outplaying everyone. She killed your negotiators and forged new documents.
So what if I did? Take me down and elves will riot in every city in the Empire.
They won't. Not when they learn you were sleeping with the woman who purged Halam Shiral's alienage. And Gaspard fell for Celine's trap and was going to attack the palace.
You've made your point. What do you want?
You are three of the best minds in the Empire. You could do so much for Orlais and your people if you stopped fighting.
It is remarkably... optimistic to believe that the three of us could ever forget our differences, Inquisitor.
I cannot believe you want to make a speech. This is foolish.
We have no choice. The nobility requires an answer for what happened.
Unless you want to pretend the war was all a dream. That would go over well. No more dithering. We make the cut swift and clean. Kindest to all of us.
Lords and ladies of the court, we are pleased to announce that an accord has been reached. Our cousin Gaspard will now hold a place of honor in our cabinet.
Friends, we assembled are the leaders of the Empire. We must set the example for all Thedas. We cannot be at war with each other, while the Fade itself challenges our borders.
We must stand united, or surely we will fall alone.
We will save Thedas from calamity, but only together may we accomplish this.
We will heal our wounded country. A long road of reconstruction lies before us. But tonight, we celebrate the arrival of peace. Let the festivities commence!